Welcome back. All new here at 4 o'clock. Nearly 50,000 people die by suicide in the U.S. in last year, according to estimates from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. So that number has steadily risen over the past 2 years, which is not what we want to hear. And this month, National Suicide Prevention Awareness Month. So joining us in studio to discuss this is Sarah Belstock with Denver Health. Sarah, thank you so much for being here.
Absolutely.
Let's talk about Prevention Month. Where did this idea come from and why is it important?
Yeah, National Suicide Prevention Awareness Month is really a time for us to share really important information about this topic, to take some time to remember and honor those that we've lost, and to advocate for better access to mental health services for everyone. It's also a good time for us to remember that we all can play a role in preventing suicide.
And we've seen, we just heard, over the last 2 years, the numbers have risen and they continue to go up. Is there any contributing factors, or what can people do to stop these numbers from going up?
Well, one thing we can do is to reach out if we are concerned about a friend or a loved one. And so if there's someone that we're concerned about, we really encourage folks to really connect with them and ask them directly if they're thinking about suicide. So just reaching out and saying, hey, I've noticed that you've been having a really hard time lately, and I'm concerned that you might be thinking about suicide. Is that something that you're thinking about? You need to ask a direct question if you want to get a direct answer.
And sometimes these things come out of nowhere. Is there any signs, especially parents? We've talked about youth suicide a lot. Is there anything parents or signs that they can look for their kids?
Yeah, I think if we see like really changes in behavior, and so, you know, if a child or really anyone is really showing just large changes in behavior, mm-hmm. if they changes in eating or sleeping patterns and things like that, those are always really good times to check in with someone and just mm-hmm. to see how they're feeling. And again, ask those direct questions.
And probably the most important question I'm going to ask you right now, and my last question is, if you do recognize these signs, how can you get help? What are the resources available?
Absolutely. One of the most important things you can do is to give people hope and let them know that help is available. And one of the best resources out there is the Suicide and Crisis Lifeline. So that is 988. Folks can text or call 988 or chat the 988lifeline.org. And that is an ability to access 24/7 crisis counselors.
Such important information, such an important topic, and life-saving information. Sarah, thank you so much for being here this afternoon.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks for having me.